On Friday, March 11, the Spirit of the Lord will usher a time of leaping and rejoicing. As you know, the 13th month is a leap month, a leap time. Remember, I told you back in Abib 5776, now they call it Nisan, that you will leap in 5776 for joy. And the time of rejoicing is in the 13th month. But for you to encounter such happiness, you have to first him and his sons and all his friends. My question for you: did you identify, expose, and kill your Haman? Guess what? If you have not done so, you are in trouble. You are not going to get your happiness, your well-deserved happiness. Like I said to you, Haman is any type of hindrance that the devil had set up in your way to destroy you. Now, let's do the work together, because I don't want you to miss it. What is your Haman? Let's take it. Wow. Until you put to rest your lingering problem or sin or generational curse, you will never inherit the kingdom of God and its promises. My God, my God. In 1 Samuel 15, verse 22 to 23, we read, Samuel replied, "Does the Lord delight in burnt offering and sacrifices as much in obeying the voice of the Lord?" That's your question. My God, my God. Let's continue. "To obey is better than sacrifice, and to heed is better than the fat of rams, for rebellion is like the sin of divination, and arrogance like the evil of idolatry." My God, my God. If you get that, guess what? You are on your way to repent and get your breakthrough. What I'm saying to you, God doesn't care about your offering, big or small. Actually, if you don't think as much as we need the financing, if you don't think that you are not going to obey God, keep your offering. God doesn't need it, because you will not be blessed. God doesn't care about your offering. Although in Adam, the required offerings are the Hekel Todah and the Shatah Todah. Hekel Todah, that means temple offering. Shatah Todah, sin offering. But let's do some thinking here, because I'm saying to you, the Lord wants you to think. Imagine you sin a temple offering, and you have not built your temple. You think you are going to get blessed? Wasting your money. Keep it, keep it. Amen and amen. You set a sin offering and you continue to sin. Wasting your time. Wasting your time. You set a time and it's not your 10%. You set a first fruit and it is not the first of your produce. Amen and amen. You set a piece of a ring and you are out there looking for trouble. Wasting your time, keep it, keep it, keep it. This is what Samuel is saying. Obey is better than sacrifice. And I'm going to add something to that. In order for you to enter the glory and victory, remember I told you, you must fast and pray. That sacrifice right there. This sacrifice will not bear fruit for the disobedient. Imagine you are a sinner, a disobedient, you say, I'm going to fast. Go eat, go eat. You know, go eat, you know. Oh, you pray and then you turn around sinning. Don't waste your time. Go out there, enjoy whatever you do. Rebellion is like the sin of divination. My God, my God. Lucifer, imagine, the angel of light, was found wanting to supplant God. That means you want to be like Lucifer. You want to be like your own God. Yes, his desire is to be worshipped and be like God. Amen and amen. When you are a sinner, this is why I'm worshiping my God. Forget about your 10 commandments. I got my commandments here. Oh no! That's the problem. And you want the blessing. But the Lord said for me to tell you, if you are your own God, so bless yourself. You are your own God, bless yourself. Look at the devil. You want to be his own God? Look at him now. You see him, you are going to war. He's the ugliest thing. There is no light in him. And he was the angel of light. My brothers, my sisters, if you get it, you are willing to do the work, the penitent work, you are going to be blessed. But you want the priest to do it for you. Guess what? After Saul committed the sin and refused to kill Agag, and this is the same spirit of Agag that entered Haman because they are related from the bloodline. Amen and amen. I preach about it already. In 1 Samuel 15, verse 32 and 33, we read. Then Samuel said, bring me Agag, king of the Amalekites. Agag came to him confidently and thinking, surely the bitterness of death is past. But Samuel said, as your sword has made women childless, so will your mother be childless among women. And Samuel put Agag to death before the Lord at Gilgal. Guess what? This week, on the 21st of Adar, 1, I did 2 sessions of casting out false spirit. The priest is there to cast out false spirit from your life. But guess what? The foul spirit, like I said, Samuel put Agag to death, but the spirit, you know, appeared. That means the spirit will come back to test you. Probably come with 7 other spirits. The priest can put Agag to death, but we see his spirit was still alive in Haman. Mordecai and Esther had to confront Agag, because Saul, their ancestor, did not do the job assigned for him to do. This is why I say to you, your Haman could be a generational curse coming back over and over again. This is why you see, you know, the father was a thief, you know, and the son said, oh, I've got to steal. You see what I'm saying? You know, amen? But where are we in prophecy? We are in a door. And a door, like I said to you, this spirit will stay there for 60 days. You have one more month to complete the work and enter the bliss of God's good will. My brothers, my sisters, some of you, hallelujah, I received the report, the testimonials. Some of you are already receiving the sweet fruit of repentance. They said, oh boy, my heart, I feel totally light. And amen. You know what they do? They kill Haman. His sons, probably your Haman got sons and friends. Amen. And they are right now witnessing, amen, the glory, the splendor of the Lord in the form of new jobs, new promotions, new raises, new houses, new cars, financial increase. People are getting engaged. Reconciliation, peace, harmony, joy unspeakable. All these things, they are yours to receive. The Lord said, you shall leap like calves. And amen. During the 13th month. But I have to tell you, if you want to take hold of this blessing, the Lord said, tell them, 107, seed of transformation, send that. Hekal Toda and Shata Toda are the requirements. However, if you need peace, send a Jesus peace offering. Like I said, don't send it and look for trouble. You want your guilt to be taken away, send a guilt offering. Amen? But you cannot keep the guilt and say, oh, I feel so guilty. Go online. Read about the offering. Don't send it just, let me pick one. No. Like I said, offering with purpose, willing to obey, believing. Amen and amen. If you do that, I'm going to give you 5 dates. 5 dates. The whole month is a month of joy, but 5 key dates for you. March 11, March 13, March 23, March 24, and March 25th will bring, hallelujah, great deliverance in the form of breakthrough. Suddenly, something that you wanted, it's yours. A problem, a situation, get corrected. Hallelujah. I cannot tell you, two or three Haman fall down. Amen, amen. Actually, the whole month of Adar 2 shall feel for many like the time when the Israelites were preparing to leave Egypt for good. Remember, Moses was telling them, okay, we are going to leave. And you imagine practically 8 million people just decided in one day to leave. That's some consensus right there. So, in order for you to be blessed, you must see yourself in that situation. You know, this is it. I need my change. I need it, and I need it now. Amen and amen. Egypt, the house of bondage. That's the meaning of Egypt. Some of you, you love Egypt. and you know, you are tied up. Amen and amen. Like Moses, I would say, you may encounter a desert in your way to your promised land. Yes.
We say, oh boy, I live in Egypt now in the desert. I said, Moses, what's going on here?
The journey
is yours alone to take.
That's right.
Yeah, that's it. Help me here. You have to make the decision and leave Egypt. Otherwise, we're going to leave you behind.
Amen and amen.
And the Lord said, Patrick, like Moses, you may have to cover your face. A lot of people don't know what I'm talking about. What I'm saying, the splendor of the Lord shall be upon me. Shall be upon me. Because Moses said, hallelujah, I'm going. This is it. You want to follow me? Follow me.
Amen and amen. Let the splendor of the Lord be even greater. Let the rain of his blessing overflow my life and yours. The righteous shall walk toward their promise in 5777. Because at the end of this month, we are entering a new year in the Lord's calendar. But the wicked shall be put out and left behind, said the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.
The Spirit of the Lord is upon me because he has anointed me to preach the gospel to the world, to heal the sick, to pray for the afflicted, and reveal unto them the purpose of God for their lives. Surely, the Sovereign Lord does nothing without revealing his plan to his servants, the prophets. The Lord wants me to give you an opportunity to be a part of his movement through Lord Jesus' house of prayer. According to Malachi 3 verse 8 to 12, you can do so by sending your tithes and offering online or to the address listed on our website. All tithes and offering are prayed over, and whatever words the Spirit will bring forth, these I will report, and the Lord promised to bless you and to open for you the floodgates of heaven. Remember, we are here for you to help you turn your house into a house of prayer. Amen and amen.